So when it comes to external USB devices, a common error that can come up is this one. USB device not recognized. Well, if that's you, then you're in luck because you've come to the right place. Today, I'm going to be giving you the top three methods that you can use to fix this error, and we're starting right now. All right, so before we start this video, I do just want to quickly say that this video will cover the top three best methods for fixing the USB device not recognized error on your Windows computer, but it is far from exhaustive. So if you need more information, I will also include a link to an article that you can read all about that gives you all of the methods in detail that you can try one by one to fix the error if the methods in this video are not successful. But with that said, let's move on to method number one, which is going to be removing as many fail points along the chain of connectivity as possible by just plugging your USB drive directly into your computer. So what I'm really talking about here are USB hubs. And while they can be an amazing way to expand your computer's I/O capacity, they can be a point of failure, especially if you don't have the necessary power for your connectivity needs. And so a simple test you can do is to remove the USB drive from the hub and connect it to one of the ports on your PC and see if that solves the error. And if this does in fact fix the problem, this is both good news and bad news. It means that your USB device is not broken, but the USB hub is the problem, and you'll likely need to invest in a powered USB hub or strip that is capable of handling multiple USB devices at one time with no issue. Now, some additional troubleshooting that you can try beyond this is to try both USB 3.0 and 2.0 ports. So depending on the age of the drive and the technology that it's using, this could provide some advantage and even cause a solution to be found for the issue. Or what you could even do is try and connect it to the USB ports on the back of your computer, which would be just essentially connecting it directly to your motherboard, which is another way that you can troubleshoot the whole USB hub issue and make sure that it's not an issue with the USB drive itself. Alright, so next up on the list is for all of my laptop users out there, and that is making sure that your computer is not selectively limiting I/O access for different ports to save power. So the laptops of today come packed with lots of amazing features. However, it comes at the expense of power from the battery, of course. So to combat this, features have been implemented into a lot of modern Windows PCs that limit the power draw of certain features in order to save power and extend battery life. And sometimes this can even include USB ports through a feature called Selective Suspend, which disables ports to save power. Now the obvious problem here is that the wrong port could be disabled at the wrong time, resulting in an interruption of connectivity between the two devices. It's not common, but it's not outside the realm of possibility. And so disabling this feature could in fact solve the issue. And here's how to do it. Click the Start button and search Edit Power Plan, and then hit the first result. Then click Change Advanced Power Settings, then expand the USB settings, and then the USB Selective Suspend setting. And just go ahead and disable it and click Apply. So now, if disabling Selective Suspend actually allows your USB drive to be recognized by the computer once again, then you know that that was the issue, and you should probably leave it disabled at the expense of battery life, because it's safer for your files and for your drive, and your peace of mind. Alright, so the third and final solution goes for desktop users as well as laptop users, and that is to update your BIOS. Now, you're probably asking yourself, what in the world is the BIOS? Well, without getting too technical on you, the BIOS is essentially a small chip on your motherboard that essentially fires everything up all at once as soon as you turn on your PC. And it's a critical way that all of the components of your computer talk to one another, including all of the inputs and outputs on the back of the motherboard as well as on the front of your computer. And so, keeping that in mind, if you have an outdated BIOS version, that can cause a lot of hiccups in not just the way that USB devices are recognized on your computer, but really the functionality of your computer as a whole. And so if you check your current BIOS version against the current version of whatever BIOS you happen to have, and it is out of date, then an update is definitely in order. Now, something important that I really have to get clear here is that these next steps that I'm about to go over should be used as general guidelines, as a supplement to official instructions from your motherboard manufacturer. Failure to adhere to proper procedure or a sudden loss in power while you're trying to update your BIOS can be catastrophic for your computer and cause a brick or even cause something like a motherboard replacement to be in order. So if you have any doubts at all or you're not confident in your ability to update your BIOS, then it may be beneficial to have it professionally done. But if you do want to give it a shot yourself, then here are some general instructions that you can follow to get the task done. Press the Windows key and S and search MS Info. Then open System Information and take note of the BIOS version. Then go to the website of your computer's manufacturer and check the latest BIOS version available for your machine. Every manufacturer will have a different update process. Some will provide an automatic updater, and others will require a manual update, which can be more difficult. But that's really the gist of it. Once you actually get the individual instructions from your manufacturer or your motherboard manufacturer to actually update your BIOS, and you do it successfully, then go ahead and give the USB drive another shot, and if it's fixed, well then, you're good to go. And with that, that is going to conclude today's tutorial on how to fix the USB device not recognized error on your Windows PC, the top three methods. Hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and if you did, always be sure to leave us a like down below. And also, if you have any questions or concerns, leave us a comment down below. I always enjoy reading your guys' comments on every video. But that is going to be it for today's video. My name is Andrew, and until next time, thank you for watching.